Welcome back, my art friends. Today we are going to paint a picture of a kid making a snow angel. It is snowing here in southern Indiana. We are on our second snow day in a row, and so I thought this would be fun. So the colors you're going to need are blue, purple, white, green, red, yellow, black, and brown. Don't forget to have your brushes. I use my 1-inch flat brush as well as my number 10, 4, and 1 round brush. Don't forget to have a cup of water for cleaning and a rag or a paper towel. And today, since it's cold here, make sure you have like hot coffee or hot cocoa. Mine's coffee today. So let's get started with our background. I am going to use my 1-inch flat brush, and we are gonna make our little snow angel friend right down here in this area. So I'm actually just gonna take white paint and make a big white circle because I want this area to be just a little bit lighter for our snow angel to go in. So with that being a nice big white circle, I know it's really hard to see, right? But then I'm gonna take some blue and some purple on my brush. I did not wash the white off. And I'm just gonna kind of start making circles around this. I want this to be a light purplish blue color that gets darker off to that corner. So over here, it's gonna be mostly blue and purple, but the rest of this area, there's gonna be a lot of white mixed in with that blue and purple. Now that I got my base colors laid on, I'm gonna wipe my brush off to keep it kind of clean. And I'm just gonna pull these colors left to right. It's okay if it goes right over the circle, because as you can see, my circle will be a little bit lighter. Wipe that off. I'm gonna add a little bit more white to this area right here. And then I'm gonna do it again. Maybe this doesn't have to be circle perfect because, you know, we're messing with it. I'm not gonna wipe my brush off. I'm gonna go straight across and pull these colors up again. All right, we're gonna let our background dry. When we come back, we will add in our little snow angel maker and some snowflakes. With a dry background, I'm gonna go in with my number 10 round brush and lay out where our little snow angel's gonna go. So like I said, they're gonna lay right here in this corner. So I'm gonna lay down the person, and then we're gonna put in the snow angel. So I'm gonna start with some white paint. I always like to draw everything with white paint. And up here, I'm gonna make this head, and we're making more of a cartoony person, okay? So just a circle head's fine. From there, I'm just gonna make two lines that kind of droop down. Those are gonna be the shoulders. Now, this child is bundled up, so this is a big old coat, right? So we're gonna kind of make like a triangle-ish shape that goes up towards the head. And then the two little legs are gonna be spread out a little bit. So just two little rectangles. This one we might even lose off the edge of the canvas, which is fine. Let's go ahead and thicken these arms up a little bit by just making bubbles around them. And we'll put little teeny tiny feet on, because you know, we're making cartoons. So little teeny tiny feet and maybe little teeny tiny hands with mittens on. So mittens kind of look like hearts that have one side that's big and one side that's small. So now that we have our person laid out, we're gonna go ahead and start adding in our colors. So I'm going to make this child's pants brown. So I'm gonna make a light brown color for the pants. So I've got some brown and some white on my brush. I'm thinking these probably look a little bit like Carhartts. All right, so a little bit of light brown for the pants. And then for the top, I'm going to make it a green color. So I wipe my brush off, I'm gonna grab some green paint. If you want this to be a bright green, you know, bright green's like my favorite color, I'm gonna add a little bit of yellow to it, which is gonna brighten up the green. But you could choose any colors you want for your jacket and pants. So mix those colors up, and I'm gonna do all my jacket with this light green color. wash that brush off, and I'm gonna go in with my skin tone. Now, you can make your skin tone any color you want, you know, just edit the colors. I'm gonna try to make a light tan color. So I'm gonna use a little bit of brown, some white, and maybe a spot of yellow to mix up my color. If you have a skin tone color that you have at your house, awesome, use it. That's not one of the colors I keep on hand because I don't normally paint people. In fact, unless it's a request, I try really hard not to. They are not my forte, but I do like to be pushed a little bit every once in a while to make myself a little better. So that's what I'm working on today. With my light brown color, my light tan color, I'm just gonna paint this whole entire circle in. And we're gonna put a hood on this little kiddo as well as a scarf, so you don't have to get the whole area perfect, but you do wanna get the skin tone on. All right, wash my brush and set it aside. I'm gonna now grab my smaller brush, my number 4 round brush. And with that round brush, I'm gonna make the hood that is attached to the jacket that's going right around the kiddo's head. So with that really light green color that I mixed up, I am going to follow this all the way around. If you want to, you can even take a little bit of a white color and kind of dab it around the edge to make it look like there's a fluffy collar to it. Just a little bit of white paint and dabbing it around the edge makes it look like there is some fluff to the front of that. I never noticed the fluff kept me any warmer, but it sure did catch a lot of snowflakes when I was a kid. I'm gonna make my boots black with the same brush, just a little bit of black paint filling those boots. I'm gonna make my mittens red. While our first layer of our snow angel is drying, we're gonna go ahead and add some snowflakes into our sky. I'm gonna zoom you in for this and show you how to make a couple different kinds of snowflakes, and then you're gonna be on your own to add as many as you want, wherever you want. So snowflakes, they kind of all start the same-ish direction, right? It's lines that cross over each other. So you can start with either an X, like this, and then you could put like a plus sign in the middle of it and have 8 legs to your snowflake. Or you can start off with a line that goes across and then an X that goes over it. And then you could have one that has 6 legs to it. So it's really up to you how you want to start your base of your snowflake. And then snowflakes are really kind of made up of series of lines and dots and angled lines. So what I mean by that is you can add some angled lines on the ends of these. So it almost looks like there's little arrows pointing out. And you can call it a done snowflake. But you can also go in and you can add like double arrows. You can call it done there too. Another thing you could do is just make little stars like this and call those done, or even use the back of your brush and make polka dots. I'm gonna make another one right here to show you another way. So on this one, I'm gonna add dots to the ends of each of these. And I'm gonna add a circle in the center part right here. And then maybe an arrow going down this way this time. So like I said, there's an endless number of possibilities. They say that snowflakes, there's never two snowflakes that are alike. So none of your snowflakes have to be the same as any other snowflake. You can kind of experiment and play with these, make some big ones, make some small ones, but I'm gonna put myself in speed motion and I am going to knock out my snowflakes all around my little snow angel. Now that my snowflakes are done and my little snow angel is ready, it is time to add on some decorations. So I have got my number one round brush and I'm gonna give my little snow friend some hair. I'm gonna go right over there. So just a curved line and then right here. I'm gonna fill that in and I'm gonna add a little bit of highlight to it. So just go right around my fluffies around my hood. I'm gonna wipe that brush off and I'm gonna take just a small amount of black paint and just add a couple of black lines. I'm talking itty bitty skinny lines just to show that there's a little bit of movement and there's some lines in the hair. Like I said, I'm making a super cartoon kid. So if you want to go in and add all the details, feel free to. But I am keeping this incredibly simple. So with some watered down black paint, I'm going to make two little eyes that are curved like frowny faces. And then I'm going to make a little nose that is curved like a little smiley face. And then I'm going to switch to a pink color. So I'm going to take a little bit of white, mix it with a little bit of red for my lips, a light pink color, and I'm going to make this cute little light pink smile. Then I am going to add some details onto his coat and then also a scarf. So I'm actually going to switch over to my number 10 round brush. I'm going to make my scarf purple. So my purple's a really dark purple, so I'm gonna add some white to it, lighten it up a little bit. So with my light purple, I am going to make a line that just kind of starts right here at his shoulder and kind of comes down across the chest. And this one will be a little bit shorter, but going this direction. With that same color in my itty bitty brush, I'm gonna make the little tassels on the edge. And you know, you can use polka dots or stripes, you could decorate that any way you want. But I'm gonna go back to my watered down black paint because I'm gonna add some details on the jacket. So right here on the edge of the jacket, I'm just gonna make a couple of straight lines up. This is where the elastic is on the jacket. So right here, as well as along the belly. I'm gonna make a line that goes up the jacket. This is where my jacket opens and closes from. Even add a couple of pockets in here with some curved lines. Add a couple of pockets on these as well. And then I'm gonna do what I call a ghost line. And a ghost line is a line that sometimes you see and sometimes you don't, but it outlines an entire figure. So for example, when I go around this, I might do a ghost line where you kind of see the line, but it also kind of doesn't show up. And this is a very, very, very skinny, thin line. So you can choose to skip this part or even do it with a Sharpie later when it's dry. But I'm gonna go around my snow child's entire body and add a black ghost line. Now let's talk about our snow angel. Okay, I think we're to the point where we need to work on our snow angel. I am gonna use watered down whitish blue paint. So a ton of white, a spot of blue, and very watery. And with this mixture, I am going to make what looks like the snow angel's arms. So, my snow angel, it's gonna be here, and I'm just gonna kind of come out and around and back. Out and around and back. Same thing with the legs, I'm gonna go out and around. Out and around. And then I'm just gonna pull these lines out. I don't want it to be totally, completely filled in. I want it to be very light, which is why I have that super watered down paint. And then again, kind of go from that area and just cover up that line I made just a little bit. And then with a little bit of clean white paint, I'm just gonna kind of dab along these edges. Cause you know, when you make those snow angels, you're pushing the snow kind of up and away. So just dabbing a little bit along these edges. I'm gonna have to redo that snowflake a little bit. So if you've got a snowflake that accidentally fell in your line of your snow angel, all you have to do is after you're done and it's dry, just repaint that snowflake on. Not a big deal. It can go right over top because the snowflakes are falling on our friend. Last couple things I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use a little bit of white paint as a little bit of highlight to highlight the front of the pants. So just almost no paint. Just kind of rub that in just to make that top part a little bit brighter and lighter. Same thing on the arms of the jacket, just a little bit of white on the top to kind of brighten it up a little bit. So I'm using my number 10 round brush with almost no white paint. I'm just kind of brushing it on top. I'm right here along that zipper. And then a little bit on the crest of the hood. I'm gonna add a couple of snowflakes falling on top of our snow angel. I'm gonna clean up my one that I lost right here. All right, my painting friends. Now we have our cute little snow angel. I hope you all are staying warm. Feel free to add your kiddo's name in this corner. It would look adorable. But don't forget, when you're finished, you need to pick a color that will show up on your canvas and sign your artwork. Don't forget that I never get to see what you're making unless you post it to our Facebook page, Painting with a Purpose. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and as always, stay kind, stay creative, and stay safe. Have a great day, friends. Bye now.